In this video, I'm just going to do some basic DC wiring for you, show you the ins and outs and how to make proper connections. Let's get to it. First, we're going to need some tools. The most important thing that you'll be needing to make connections is, of course, connectors. You can get a cheap set like this with all of the buck connectors you need. In this video, I'm not going to get into the proper soldered connections and all that stuff for those applications. I'm just going to get into the basic way how to use these properly and do a simple circuit. Something else I recommend getting is just a cheap multimeter, and this one I can set to 20 volts direct current. All right, we're not going to really use this in this video, but if you need to test circuits, it's a really cheap way to do so. Negative to negative, positive to positive, and that's a charged battery, 2.8 volts. Okay, then strippers and crimpers, and I can put a link to these down in the description. This is kind of an all-in-one tool I like to use. I carry these everywhere. And it has strippers, crimper, and pliers, cutters, all in one. Then, of course, some wire. All right, let's get to it. Basically, I want to be able to turn this light on with the flick of a switch. It's just an LED light, an old style light bulb. It doesn't matter which way you wire it, it'll turn on. LEDs, generally, you have to find the hot wire. On this setup, it is a black wire with a white stripe. Let's hook this up real quick. Positive over here on the left, negative. And we have a light. I don't recommend touching lead. That's not a good idea. Don't be like me. That's not gonna work there. I'm not gonna be hanging out somewhere, you know, needing light and just gonna hold these wires onto terminals. So let's get this thing wired up. The main thing I wanna show you about making proper connections is this right here. This is just a standard buck connector, of course. That's for connecting two wires. You strip the ends of the wires and stick them in there. Most people just take their pliers and crush them down, or they just shove them in the crimper like so, and crush each end. Well, that works okay, but you can get a bad connection that way. A buck connector with no insulator on it. And something I wanna show you is there is actually a small crack right there where the two pieces meet up to make the tube. Now, the crimper has to be on there a certain direction. I'm gonna move this around a little bit so you can see, but there's a crack on this curved side over here, and this pointy side is on the complete part. So that way when I crush it down, it doesn't push these ends all in weird directions and make a bad connection. And you place your wire inside. Now let's crimp it down. Look, that's solid. It's not gonna pull out. Now I'm gonna do it extremely bad just to show you how it can turn out. Let's just put them on there sideways, the completely wrong direction. Crimp it down. Okay, now the connection looks okay, but oh, yep. It split and moved, and it's misaligned the entire buck connector. So let's avoid that. Always crimp with this on the proper side. Now that we have the proper method for crimping, these are a lot easier. You always put the top on that curved side over there, and then the pointy side goes on the bottom of these. And you can see in there, the split is on the top, and the crimp is on the bottom. Now these are way too big eyelets for this wire, but we're just gonna use it for these purposes. It will be fine. Another habit you wanna get into when you're making these connections, you strip your wire and then always twist it to the right clockwise. And that'll be something handy in the future if you're doing AC wiring on your house at some point when you get used to this kind of stuff. If you twist to the right, your wing nuts always work properly, and that's how electricians do it. That's crimped down. And trim that off, strip it. I'm gonna get the small buck connector, which is usually red in these kits. Set that in there, make sure my crimper is aligned. Crimp that one, and then I can repeat the same crimp on the next one. I already know which direction I need to go. All right, black wire to black wire. We now have the negative wire attached to our light. I could just hook this wire directly up and it would turn on. But that's not gonna work. I wanna use a switch. These take spade connectors. Now, these are male spade. We're gonna find the female spade, add them to our wires, and plug them onto our switch. Again, checking, I'm aiming this the right direction. So power to our switch. All a switch does, the only function, is connecting and disconnecting the wire. There's nothing fancy going on in here. It literally is just touching two contacts together, just like we do with the wires. Another name for a switch is an interrupter. That means it just interrupts the flow. Now, we have the power on a switch. I flip this switch, light, of course. Now, any lights or an electric motor or a radio or whatever. You want to put a fuse on this circuit, and we'll show you why in a moment. And you want the fuse on the load side in between as close as you can to the battery or your circuit board. And the reason why is you want to protect this entire circuit from grounding out to something metal and just burning the wire in half. That's what the fuse does, is instead of burning the wire in half, your fuse will burn out first, keeping your vehicle or boat safe. Okay, I'm just gonna connect that side because it already has a spade on there. Connect this side to the switch. Okay, that is a simple device, easy to wire up, easy to set up for your application. Now this one, I have a 3-amp fuse. That's about the smallest one I have in the shop. That'll never blow out from actually just running this little light. Down in the description, I will link an ampacity chart. That'll tell you what size wire you need to use. This is a wire you run accessories or small stuff on a car or boat. This, I'm bringing into the frame, are battery cables. Obviously, whatever this is running, starting a boat motor, is a whole bunch more juice it can handle. You find the amp rating on the device you're trying to power, like a subwoofer, for instance. It'll tell you how many amps of wire or what gauge wire you need. You can reference your chart and buy the proper wire. All right, so I'm gonna show you what happens when you do not have a fuse. I'm demonstrating a short to ground. Whenever I flip this switch, it's gonna connect positive and negative on this battery. Now, let's see what happens. That is why you want to insulate your wires, and you want to always use proper connections and fuses. Well, now you know how to do some basic DC wiring. If you want to see my crazy houseboat, check this video out.